Hello and welcome to another RPG example video. Well, today I'm going to continue talking about activation groups. In this case, I'm going to show you an example using an SQL cursor. The first thing I want to say is that you cannot use an SQL cursor in the same way as I did in my last video with a file. I mean, you cannot use an override to share the open data path. If we read the IBM documentation, the scope of a cursor is the source program in which it is defined. For example, a program called from another separately compiled program cannot use a cursor that was opened by the calling program. But we can use the activation groups for keeping an SQL cursor open and reuse it. In this video, I'm going to show you an example of this. Let's go. Okay, let me show you two sources of two programs. This one. The first program, ACT group number 7. Well, this is a very simple program that calls to another program two times, as you see here. The most important in this source is that I have specified that I want it to be run in a named activation group, as you see here. So as you know, when the program ends, the activation group will remain in memory. Okay, let's see the second source. It is this, okay. Well, in this case, as I need here SQL functions, I have created an SQL RPG source. I have also specified that I want it to be run into the quarter activation group. This is very important if I want to keep the cursor open. And also, I have specified this option here. That is very important too. It means that I want the SQL cursor to be automatically closed when the activation group is closed. As the activation group of this program is the caller program activation group, this one. And this is a named activation group. The cursor will not be removed until the activation group is removed from the system. Well, after this, I have written is a simple program that reads a file from the first record to the last record. So simple. You can see here the source. Okay, so let's compile the two programs. Let me compile this one and this other one. Okay, the two programs are now compiled. Let's see how it works. Well, as I always do, is starting a debug session. Well, let me stop it here, and let's call it. Okay. Well, this is the first thing I'm going to do is calling to this other program. If you remember, this other program is the program where we are creating the cursor and so on. So let's call to it. Okay. This program belongs to the activation group of the caller program, and this can be seen here. You can see these are the two programs running. And if I press F11, I can see the activation group of the both programs that are the same. Okay, let's go ahead. Okay. As I have this variable with the value of blanks. The cursor is declared and opened. Okay. And as I have this variable equals to blank, I'm going to fetch the first element from the SQL cursor. This can be done if the cursor is a scroll cursor, okay? And this is the scroll cursor, okay? Well, if I continue reading, okay, I have end the execution of that program. Let me show you the job. As you see, I have only this program now in my activation group running. Okay, but if I want to see the open files, this file is open, and it's open in this activation group. It is open because of the SQL cursor. The SQL cursor is still open in memory. Okay, so if I call to the program again, okay, if I continue, let me show you the content of this variable, and it is equals to Y, to yes. So I'm not going to declare or open again the cursor because it is open. Okay, so I have only to read again the file. And as I have this variable equals to blank, it is going to fetch the first element again. So I'm going to read the file from the beginning. Okay, so let me execute it. Okay, and I'm now in the first program, and the first program is going to end. Okay, as I have declared this as an activation, as a named activation group, if I see my job, the activation group is still in memory. And also, the file is still open. So I can call it again, and it will call it again to the same program, and the program is not going to open the cursor because it is open, it is still open, and it is going to start reading again the file. So I'm doing the same work all the time, but no, I'm not opening the cursor every time I call the program. Okay, how can I close this activation group? Well, as you know, we can call to this command, reclaim activation group, and it will be deleted, okay? Also, we can sign off, and it will be deleted too. If I see, I don't have the activation group in memory now. Okay, as you have seen, this is a pretty good option for reusing SQL cursors. Actually, this is the way of service programs work. It is very important to create the activation groups in the way you need, and you must always specify how the cursors are going to be closed. Changing these two options, this option, and this, the program will work in a different way. So keep an eye always on this. I hope you like this video. Please leave your comments below. Thanks for watching.